Now to start an emulator, just click on this arrow and you're ready to start off your first emulator. So let's get started with this. So click on this and close this. Now there I have my emulator running. Now this is the first time you'll be seeing this screen. I can say cut it. Now the emulator, now it works much faster than it used to run in other earlier versions of the Android Studio. We had an option of Genymotion that we used to install to make this things faster, to run the programs run faster in the emulator. But now since this emulator, it runs much, you know, closer to what Genymotion used to do. So now we won't be needing Genymotion and we'll be doing all our apps running on this emulator. So this is my Nexus 5 emulator. Now if you can see, there's a toolbar that is attached to this, a host of options that you already have. You have a power button, and if you keep your mouse stagnant on this, you can see that you have the keyboard shortcut also shown, Control plus P. This is power on. You can volume, increase the volume on this, decrease the volume with this. You can tilt to the left. You can take it back. You can take a screenshot. You can magnify this. And you can go back to the previous screen. We can move to the home screen. And then there are a host of options that you have here. Now what all do we have here? Now in case you're building some Google Maps or some location based app, then you need to simulate some location to the emulator. It needs to be sent some location through which you can, which would be the emulator's current location. That address we can simulate to the emulator through this. We can pass in a latitude, a longitude, and then you can press send. So this location is now is the emulator's location, and accordingly we can fetch data based on this location. So now with cellular, you can select what network you're targeting to be on the emulator. You can select a GSM or a GPRS edge, a high speed internet connection, or you can leave as the default as full. Then you can simulate the battery charge that the emulator has, and we can check if the notifications for the broadcast are coming when the battery level goes down. So we can simulate a low battery level and can check whether the app is receiving broadcast for battery or not. And we can simulate calls to the emulator from any number. We can simulate messages, SMS from some number to this to the emulator. And in some cases, some emulators also support the directional pad. So you can simply use the arrow keys to navigate between things. And the most important addition to this are the sensors as well as the fingerprint sensor. Now beforehand, if you need to check for fingerprint, you need to have some actual device on which you need to run the app and test for it. Now you can simply use this emulator fingerprint, and you can say touch sensor, and this will simulate as if you are actually pressing on the screen. So then you have virtual sensors, the accelerometer, and additional sensors that you can target for your emulator, and some slight settings that you could always are handy in case you need to change the screen, the keypad to be slightly in a darker shade. So these all settings you can make through the settings option. So you got locations to set, the network, battery, phone, fingerprints, all are available to you within the emulator, and we can use as we come to that particular section. Is that earlier the option to resize the phone, the emulator, used to be within the settings of the phone. Now you can just simply drag and resize. So now there is no option to size off your phone, the emulator phone. You need to drag, and whatever size you need, you can drag this to. So earlier we used to set the pixel size to, if you need 2 dp to correspond to 1 pixel, actual pixel on the screen. But now since you can just drag the size, there is no option in the AVD manager to edit the emulator and set the size. The only option you have in the options is to make this appear as portrait or landscape. So now there is no option to resize. So if you need to resize, you can do it here only.